Well, the weather outside is frightful, and the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow.
Oh, it doesn't show signs of stopping, and I bought some corn for popping. The lights are turning way down low. Let it snow.
When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. Oh, the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so,
let it snow. Let it snow. Home for the holidays. I believe I've missed each and every face. So come on and play one easy, and let's turn on every love light in the place. It's time I found myself totally surrounded in your circles. Oh, my friends.
I want to welcome everybody here and thank you for being here. And I can think of no better way of opening the Christmas season than with good friends and good music. And that's what we're going to do. What the show is about, in case you're wondering, why we're here tonight is to sort of celebrate and explore all the facets, all the colors of Christmas together. And we'll do that not only with our music, but with the stories that we tell and the memories that we share around the piano, in the living room, throughout the show. Christmas and December is a very powerful time for a lot of people. And when all is said and done, I think after the packages and the wrapping and the hustle and the bustle and all the Christmas decorations that I myself work so hard to put up every year, when all that is done and you sit back, what you're really craving is to make a heart connection with the people that you love. And it's all, I guess, just a set for that moment when people can really drop in with each other and feel what Christmas really means. So that's what I hope we'll do here tonight together.
Try this one. White Christmas. Should we try it?
Great.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know,
where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear
Christmas,
song. What a great song.
So many ways to sing that song.
Yeah.
And that was one of them.
You know, another way to sing it would be, well, what if Willie was to sing that song? You know, Willie, not Free Willie, but the other Willie.
Willie would do it more standard. Like, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Sleigh bell ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland.
Gone away is the bluebird. Here to stay is a new bird. It sings a love song as we go along. Walking in a winter wonderland. Metal, we can build a snowman and pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no man, but you can do the job while you're in town.
Later on, we'll perspire as we sit by the fire to face unafraid the plans that we made. Walking in a winter wonderland. Walking in.
You guys are good.
No, no, really, no.
That's a snapper, isn't it?
You know, Silver Bells that we ran this morning?
Silver Bells. It's funny, the first time I ever sang that song, I came to America in the early 70s, was on a Bob Hope special. He was famous for his Christmas specials in the 70s. And that was the only time I've ever sung it before, till now.
Had you heard it before?
I hadn't heard it before. I had to learn it for the show.
Yeah.
Well, Kenny will play the part of Bob.
Yeah, you be Bob.
City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air, there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner, you
that having gone through breast cancer and now, thankfully, 1992, so I'm nearly 8 years through it, I think every Christmas is extra special because every day is extra special. That I feel very fortunate to be here and make another Christmas. So every day when I wake up, I realize I'm lucky. And I think Christmas is a special day to give thanks for what you have in life.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your hearts be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight.
Have yourself Christmas. make the Yuletide gay. From now on, your troubles will be miles away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together. If the fates allow,
so hang a shining star upon the high. A merry little Christmas near to us once more. Through the years, we always will be together. If the fates allow, so hang a shining star.
I think one of the reasons why I made my own Christmas album, the album I call December, is probably because of a family tradition that my folks had when I was a little kid. Every Christmas Eve, my mother would receive the new Christmas album. You know, whether it was Perry Como or Johnny Mathis, or I remember the first Christmas music I heard was Bing Crosby singing White Christmas. And one of the songs that knocked my socks off as a little kid and still does, and that's why I did it on the show tonight, and I love so much, is Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire. It's such a beautiful tune. Mel Torme wrote it, Nat King Cole sang it, the definitive version. But I gotta throw my hat in the ring too on that one.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots
with their eyes all in glow, who find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mama's child is gonna want to spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. Many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you.
The most special Christmas present I received was when Kitty gave me a wedding ring. And it always means Christmas and Kenny, and those two things go together for me.
When I sing the song with him, it's just a special moment every time. And I almost didn't do it because I was a big fat chicken. And I didn't think I would sing it as best as it should be sung. You know, I was really scared because I haven't sung in a long time, and it's not something you just up and do. And I'm so glad now that I did it. I can't imagine having missed this opportunity, this having created this moment that we have created, that we'll be able to look back and smile upon and feel things from. And, you know, I don't know, people ask me, you know, is he romantic? Yes. What kind of things does he do? He writes me love songs. Is that ever romantic?
In these times of trouble, and these times aren't good, and they're always gonna be. They rise and they fall, and we take them all the way that we should, together you and me, forsaking them all. Deep in the night and by the light of day, it always looks the same. True love always does. And here by your side, we're a million miles away. Nothing's ever gonna change the way I feel. The way it is the way that it was. When I said I do, I meant that I will. Till the end of all time, be faithful and true. That's what I had in mind when I said I do. Now this old world keeps changing, and the world stays the same for all who came before, and it goes hand in hand. So much more,
so much more
than a woman and a man. And after everything that comes and goes around has only passed us by, here alone and
That's what I had in mind.
That's what I had in mind
when I said
on stage together doing it, I'm just, it's the thrill of my life, and it goes by in 4 minutes and it's over, and I'm left feeling just like it's too quick, and don't leave the stage, and sometimes I'll hang on to her hand and keep her from going out there and just, you know, parade her around just a little bit longer, saying, you know, there she is, she's inspired these songs in me.
So I want to welcome you to our living room and say thank you to Lisa and Clint and Olivia. And of course, once again, introduce you to my wife, Julia. Okay, so here's what we're doing. I want to take this opportunity to drop in a little bit deeper now and talk about all the different facets of Christmas. Who here remembers the first present they ever got somebody?
I got my dad. My dad called cologne Stinkum, and I thought that was really Stinkum.
Stinkum brand cologne?
Mm-hmm. And I went to the department store, and I put my money up there, and I said, I need some Stinkum for my dad.
Where were you living? Where was it?
We were in Houston, Texas.
Well, they understood that then.
Oh, yeah, yeah. She did. She came up with something very, I think it ended up being Old Spice or something, but I'll never forget that.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. What a great story.
Yeah. One of my favorite gifts from her was a floss stick.
Because I can understand that.
No, I mean, but she remembered.
It was a creative floss.
She remembered that floss just kills my fingers. I just it really gets to me.
I
get in there, I'm so aggressive, and it just floss kills my fingers. She remembered that and got me this great floss stick. It has a little wind-up thing, and all I have to do is go in there and work this floss.
You crank the floss instead of having to do it.
No, and that's all that matters. I love that.
I am creative.
I wanted five of them, so I'd always have one.
Well, it was the thought,
she remembered.
Right?
Yeah. Yes, yeah. That was important to you.
Yeah. Well, it was covered with diamonds, but, you know,
still. Tiffany's. No.
It's interesting hearing all of you speak, because now I realize how, when I was going through my cancer and I just finished all my treatment and I went to Australia, right, and that was my first Christmas kind of after I'd just finished everything. And I was in this very wonderful place, very spiritually minded. And that was very special Christmas because I made everybody something. They weren't very good, but I hand-painted picture frames for everybody. And I look at them now and I go, how could I have done it? They're so terrible. But anyway, at the time I thought they were great. And it was the first time, in my life that I can remember, I had time. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was a sad story that I had to get sick to have time.
Yeah.
But I had actually weeks to take time and think about, you know, what design and what color their living room was. And that was a special.
It's very satisfying, isn't it?
Very satisfying. Well,
when we were growing up, the most exciting thing building up to Christmas was when Dad brought home the tree and we all together decorated it.
Mm-hmm.
But we didn't really know why.
Why you were decorating.
Why we were decorating, what it all meant, what are all these things on there. We just loved it anyway.
Yeah.
And what, if we have kids, I want to do that, have that kind of fun, mm-hmm. and let them understand why, so that it has all this meaning behind it.
Let me give you one clue, though. Mm-hmm. Yeah. When you decorate a tree with kids, let go of the outcome.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't worry about what it looks like.
I think so.
I got to tell you.
I put the lights on, he redoes the lights. I put the box
on, he redoes the lights. She had a name for me.
You're not hearing me, but you got to let it go.
No, I can do that.
I tell you, I made that mistake when my oldest was only about, 3 years old, 4 years old? And actually, he helped me inadvertently create a new family tradition. He and I were at the department store, and I bought this incredibly gaudy tin foil tree star. And it had the little tiny twinkle lights all in it. Mm-hmm. And when I put it on the top of the tree, and he and I were really excited, we climb up the ladder, put it on the top of the tree, and it goes psh, 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 and it's one of these flashers, like Eat at Joe's, you know? And I'm going, oh, no, this is really tacky, you know? So after he goes to bed that night, I take the star down, and I put up a beautiful papier-mâché Christmas angel. I figure he'll forget about it. What, he's 4 years old, you know, he's going to walk out. No.
He wanted that star.
So we walk out in the morning, first thing in the morning, he walks out, he looks up and he goes, what happened to the star? Yeah. And I go, it turned into an angel. Would you look at that? And he goes, wow. And so every year,
he's waiting for the star to turn
into an angel. So I have to put up the star first. He goes to bed, and then I put up the angel. And now that he's moved out, that tradition has sort of fallen by the wayside.
Having traditions is the key. Mm-hmm.
Just going to a store and buying a thing doesn't do it. When she makes the gifts, she does it with the children, no matter how old they are. Mm. One year, she bought kites and crystals and all kinds of bizarre things from different shops and made these gigantic mobiles.
Yeah, Luke and I did it when he was 3 so that I could actually have an experience with him of making something for all his older brothers and sisters instead of just saying, oh, it's so great to give. So he went through the making them, and then he got to watch them open it. And he was actually more excited that year to have, come on, open my present, than what he got. Yeah. And now, to this day, now those mobiles are still in their rooms.
How proud that
those funky,
made,
weird mobiles.
So I want to thank you all and wish you all a Merry Christmas. I so much appreciate being with you, and let's continue this conversation up at our home.
So Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Cheers.
Cheers.
Chance of
Angels in the Snow is a song that I started melodically, and then Julia and I wrote the lyrics to it while we were in Hawaii. And I think I'll always remember writing the words about children making snow angels while we're sitting in the sand watching our children play in the water. But the emotion of the song for me really comes home at the chorus, because I see us, Julia and I, together in the future, marking time by watching our children move through these Christmas seasons, through these Decembers after Decembers.
When December comes, and we'll take the kids to Mama's, they can make snow angels in the yard like a Christmas card. We'll decorate the tree, put an angel high above us, like we always do at Christmas. Home is ever near, hearts return no matter what we do. I will always be there. knew long ago. While we watch our angels in the
I have a wonderful memory of a white Christmas in England. I was living in the countryside, and I had invited some of my best friends to come for lunch, and they brought with them their mother, who was from Australia, who had never been out of Australia and who had never seen snow, and was in the living room, and it just started to snow. It was like perfect. It was Christmas morning, about 11 o'clock, and snowflakes started coming down, and she looked out the window and she said, "Oh, look, it's snowing out front." And then she turned around and she said, "Oh, and it's snowing out the back as well."
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly
I'm very open spiritually to all beliefs, and I love the Jesus and Mary and the whole tradition of the wise men and the whole thing. I think it's a beautiful story, and it's like the birth of the birth of beauty and the birth of innocence. And and for those people who don't believe in the story of Christmas and in Jesus, I think it's more about family. But there's a spiritual side to the whole thing. I think that it's a time for thanks.
Nature replenishes.
Well, I have to say one of the biggest pleasures of my life was getting a chance to write a song with Clint Black. And I know that's
that was my line.
No, I know that's kind of a bizarre turnaround for you, but
well, it is. Growing up on your music, and it was quite a thrill. I sent a tape to Kenny and asked him if he would participate in this song, and he called me up and said that he really liked it but felt something was missing. And I said, "You mean your name is a
right
credited as a songwriter?" And he said, "Yeah, that's exactly."
I got to tell you, it took a lot of audacity on my part to call you and say, "I love the song. It's not done yet.
But we
can you come up and help, and I'll help you finish it."
But that's what I expected from you, because I mean I knew if I got you involved in the song that it would just become better somehow.
Thank you.
And it did. It came up several notches, and it's a song that's very fitting for Christmas. If there's one gift that I could give everybody for Christmas, it would be harmony, and peace. And harmony is the name of the song. So
perfect.
Yeah.
With the rivers running to the sky to rain upon the land, our children's children, sands of time are slipping through our hands. Take heed in what's become of Eden, you and me, from seed to seed. Just how does your garden grow? It's likely only heaven knows. Harmony, we're the only ones who can't live in it. Everything and everyone can get along in every way. In harmony, from the very start, weren't we changing it? Don't we all
Well, I want to thank you again for sharing this evening with me and sharing the stories and the songs that we've done together. I really appreciate it. I had a great time. I hope you did.
We really enjoyed watching you have a great time.
I appreciate it. And I think we should wrap it up with the song that I have sung for so many years and has become my Christmas anthem. Sing Celebrate Me Home Together, please.
Love that. Yeah.
For the holidays, I believe I've missed each and every face. So come on and play one easy, and let's turn on every love light in the place. It's time I found myself totally surrounded in your circles. Oh,
get Kenny Loggins' December and other great Christmas music at country.com.